樹輝傾傾傾。喂，早晨，歡迎收聽鄉樹輝傾傾傾。今日我哋呢個訪問節目咧，就係雙語啊，咁啊 bilingual 啊，咁啊有英文有廣東話嘅。咁主要因為我哋訪問嘉賓有兩位，一位咧就香港證券專業學會主席穆義堂先生咧，就係、是、Anthony Mood， 咁啊係紐西蘭嘅華僑啊，因為佢喺紐西蘭太耐咧，咁啊唔識講廣東話嘅。咁啊，另外一位咧就係、是、香港證券專業學會嘅行政總裁黃兆芬先生，咁 S.F. Wong， 咁咧黄先生当然本地人，又识讲广东话啦，所以我哋今日嘅访问嘅双语进行，咁大家咧就因为时间关啊，可能嚟唔切咧，就翻译翻做广东话俾大家听啊。不过我哋财经台嘅听众咧，就香港财经界嘅多数都系香港财经界人物啊、商界人物啊，同埋专业人士，咁相信听英文咧就冇乜难度嘅吓。咁啊，如果有唔方便嘅地方，方咧就緊此致歉。咁啊好啦，我哋第一條問題咧就問我哋嘅香港證券專業學會嘅主席啊 Anthony 啊，咁啊問啊 Anthony， 咁咧就呢個香港證券專業學會啊，咁個背景係點樣嘅咧嚇？咁又可唔可以同我哋介紹下咧
？OK， the Hong Kong Securities Institute was established in November 1997 by amalgamating the various professional societies that existed at that time.It was formed with the full support of the SAR Hong Kong government, the leading financial institutions, firms, individuals, and also, of course, the Securities and Futures Commission and the Stocks Exchange of Hong Kong and also the Futures Exchange of Hong Kong. We're here really to, I guess most people would know us in that we provide the license examination as required by the Securities and Futures Commission.For anyone who wishes to practice in the financial services industry. And beyond that, I guess we are really here to serve the financial services community. Our mission statement is firstly to set the standard of professional excellence and integrity for our members and the market participants to provide the means of attaining them as well.But also we're here really to contribute to Hong Kong's role as the leading financialan international financial centre, and lastly, to broaden the membership of our professionals and enhance the capability and reputation of our members.
咁啊，就穆先生主要讲咧吓，呢个香港证券专业学会 HKSI 咧，就系香港一个专业嘅团体，1997年11月成立嘅吓，专系为证券界嗰方面咧提供个专业嘅服务同埋呢个资格噶。咁啊，呢一方面咧，大家都知道吓，要做呢个证券行业咧，要做呢个证券专业学会考嗰啲试。咁我哋咧就跟住咧就问下黄先生先啦。咁而家香港系咪个个都要考？如果要做证券界做经纪啊，咁系咪要考呢个证券专业学会嘅试嘅咧吓？咁系咪一定要考你哋嘅咧？咁啊 HKSI 系咪一个专业嘅资格？而家有几多人去考啊？
系啊，香 Sir 就系、是、大概咧就系、是、平均每个月大概有3000人考啦。
系咪一个月3000好多人、
啊？系啊，因为就亦都因为香港系一个国际金融中心啦，咁即系都系嗰个四大经济支柱之一咧嘅金融界，咁所以就系好多人考嘅。咁刚头先你讲啦，即系如果啲年青人或者大学毕业生想进入呢、這个。金融行業嘅佢要 SFC 度攞牌啦，證監攞牌，攞牌之前咧，佢就考試嘅要嚇。
要考試咁合格率點啊？三千人考有幾人合格啊？
我哋都個合格率大概係平均都係65%-70%之間啦。
我諗都幾合格。
啊，呢個係國際性嘅水準嚟㗎，香 Sir。
係。即系国际性都系咁易合格噶系嘛？
诶，咁想系啦，系啦。
啊，咁啊，香港话每个月有3000人考都系厉害，估到香港咁多人做呢行啊！咁一年咪30000几人？
系啊，系啊，系啊，吓、啊！
哇，咁啊又系香港。
咁但系唔系话个个考咗一入行嘅向上，因为好多系譬如啲大学毕业生考定先啦，或者有啲都未必考定先啦。
即系未入做呢行都考嘅。
系啊，系啊。
总之啊，香港人中意考试啊，攞咗个牌啊，冇蚀底。
系啦，系啦。
咁啊，考咗先啊。
同埋搵工嗰时比较容易啲咯，吓。
咁啊，系搵 有啲做銀行嘅，而家都要喺賣產品都要考呢個試啦，係嘛？
係啊，係啊，
咁啊，考完咗之後啊，咁啊，希望銀行唔好炒個魷魚，考唔到，可能銀行話你未有資格喎，咁啊，叫你離開。
上考唔到就冇工做㗎，唔請嘅，
唔請係嘛？哇，咁更加要考。不過唔怕嘅，香港年輕人考試就考到慣嚇，呢、這個就咁咧就跟住問阿穆先生咧，就問阿 Anthony 啦。咁而家既然咁多人去考試啦，啊一個月有3000人啦，而家香港有幾多個、HKSI 有幾多個會員啊，幾多個 members 咧嚇？咁佢哋多數考到之後，佢哋真係做邊一啲事情嘅咧？
Okay, in terms of members, we have different criteria of members. We have corporate members, individual members, as well as student members. We have approximately 160 odd corporate members. They cover all the local, regional and international firms that operate here in Hong Kong. We have currently some 2,300 individual members and around 11,500 student members as well.In terms of the sectors, in terms of how they break down of our individual members, they are broken into covers all the different segments of Hong Kong's financial services industry, including securities, stockbroking, asset management, corporate finance, and banking. Roughly, we have over a third of our members from the securities industry. We have approximately 25% from the asset management industry.And some 12% from both corporate finance and the futures industry, respectively. And finally, a smaller percentage from the banking industry.
咁啊，主席咧就话咁啊，呢一行都好鬼死多吓会员噶，咁净系学生会员都11,500多人，咁啊，另外有企业嘅会员咧接近2,300，咁啊，考到资格嗰啲人士啊，多数从事边方面咧？咁啊，当然系从事证券业最多啦，占咗30%，咁啊，资产管理约1/4，咁啊，企业融资嗰方面咧，以及呢个期货方面咧，分别占12%左右啦，咁啊，都仲有。喺銀行界嗰方面做咧，大概6%左右。咁啊，剛才阿黃先生講過咧，考唔到牌又冇工做噶嚇。咁如果你要做呢啲證券業啊、資產管理啊、公司財務嗰方面，大概都係必考噶啦，唔考啊自己蝕底嘅啫嚇。咁啊，一定咧就係要去參加呢個考試先得嘅。咁啊，香港人啊最多啊去考呢個試噶啦嚇。咁啊，如果要考呢個試啊，問下 Anthony 啊，咁。呢、这個 HKSI 啊，咁對呢、这個啊啲會員啊提供啲咩服務咧
？Okay, before we talk about service, one other important point of our membership, I think it's worth noting, is that over a third of our individual members are all they are either chairman or the CEO of their respective organisations. So our memberships are very senior.They are the leaders in our financial services industry here in Hong Kong.
哦，咁啊，佢哋啲會員有好多都係 CEO 嚟喎嚇，或者證券界嘅高層咁啊。呢、這個當然啦，以身作則噶嘛。咁自己做阿 boss 嗰個考唔到，咁點叫啲夥計去考啦？係嘛？咁或者考唔到嗰個都唔係 boss 嚟嘅。但係多一個啦，咁有冇得 grandfather 嘅咧？咁啊，以前做咗40年啦，佢唔會考試咁，可以 grandfather 咗佢俾個會員資格佢噶啦，黃生。
香 Sir， 会员资格同考试系分开嘅，吓、做会员咧就唔使一定系要要考试合格嘅，但系 of course 啦，即系我哋好多会员都系已经系做攞考试格，所以就系分开嘅，会员唔一定要考试嘅，考试未必要做会员嘅。
哦，咁啊，如果有啲老牌经纪50年前已经做噶啦，咁你而家叫佢考试，佢未必考到
嘅。系啦，咁佢就申请会员就冇问题噶啦、
啊。做会员就冇问题啦，但系做会员可唔可以后下边写住 FHKSI 咁样
？MHKSI member。
member 佢、啊、就唔可以 F 嚟
嘅 ，F 咧就 fellow 咧就系咧要对一个业界有资好资深嘅从业员啦，或者同埋要响我哋个会帮我哋做一啲服务啦。做嗰啲委員會嘅工作嘅，就好似 fellow， 咁我哋仲有一個叫做榮譽，就 honorary fellow， 嗰啲咁嘅財經界嘅who's who 嘅香水，好似舊年啊史美倫女士啦，
前、
年啊Edgar 鄭維健啦，
咁啊佢哋都做過主席啊，肯定唔使佢考試噶啦好，我哋而家先休息一陣。
香樹輝傾傾傾。
今日我哋访问嘅嘉宾啊，双语啊吓，咁啊，第一位咧就香港证券专业协会嘅主席穆如堂先生 Anthony Mood， 第二位咧就系呢个香港证券专业学会嘅行政总裁黄兆芬先生，咁就系穆主席咧就喺纽西兰翻嚟嘅，咁啊嗰啲广东话唔灵光啊，讲唔掂，咁啊要讲啊英文嘅，咁啊刚才咧我问过佢啦，就话嗰个。FHK 呢个 HKSI 咧，香港证券专业学会咗好多会员噶，咁究竟收咗咁多会员，一年有每一个月有3000人考试合格啦，大概60%至70%左右吓，咁啊都好多人合资格嘅，咁多个会众多会员之中啊，究竟呢个证券专业协会对佢哋提供咗啲咩嘅服务咧？咁做 member 有咩好处啦？
Right, the services we provide to both our members but also to the general financial services communities fall into three core categories. The first, of course, is our license examination, as I had talked about previously. Anyone who's going to practice here in Hong Kong needs to sit this examination, and we ensure that the license examination is of international quality and standards. The second part is to help and facilitate.For the Hong Kong practitioners to attain internationally recognised qualifications. Most people obviously know the CFA, but we have a qualification that's equivalent to that called CIIA, Certified International Investment Analyst, which is recognised here in Hong Kong, but indeed all around the world, including, very importantly, mainly in China. And there are others which we can discuss later on.And the third is to provide continuous training for our community. And this is a very important part of our service to ensure that our practitioners here in Hong Kong are continuously updated in the latest practices and also rules and regulations.
咁啊，香港人考試咧最緊要咧就除咗香港去執業之外咧，仲要去到內地咧得到承認噶咁啊，而家又有 CIPA 嗰方面啦，新政府上台啦，咁啊又嚇可能又係自己復 CIPA 嘅專家，咁啊將來啲專業人士去到內地啊做事咧，咁啊利用香港考到嘅專業資格啦，可能啲嚟嘅。咁啊，黃兆芬咧問下你啦，咁啊而家你哋啲從業員啊呢、這個行業從業考到呢、這個啊 HKIS。又去到內地會唔會受到認可咧嚇？咁啊攞住呢個資格去內地發展啊，咁又得唔得咧？
阿香 Sir 係得嘅。咁我哋五年前咧，因為CIPA 嘅架構之下咧，就證監同國內證監係有互認資格呢樣嘢嘅。咁同埋咧，就我哋都五年前開始咧，就香港嘅從業員可以考國內嘅法例法規試。同時間響國內響。上海同埋深圳咧，每一年我都舉辦兩次，就係考我哋香港嘅卷一，就係關於法例法規嘅。即係換句話說，如果香港嘅從業員考咗國內嘅法例法規合格嘅話咧，將來入去內地咧就可以申請牌照啦。係，咁同樣就係內地嘅從業員都可以咁樣嚟香港申請牌照嚇。
哦，咁佢哋你哋唔會保護主言俾佢嚟嘅。
哦，咁係 CIPA 係即係大家互認，大家開放大家嘅市場噶嘛。
係咁啊，另外咧就而家我哋做財經台啦，咁啊每日咧都講緊財經新聞啦，咁啊呢個幾兩個月嚟咧就經常都睇到啲所謂民企風暴啊、民企爆煲啊嗰啲㗎，咁啊而家證監會最近咧就新嘅行政總裁啊。Ashley Alder 咧就啊宣布咧就话可能要收紧对呢啲保荐人嘅监管，咁啊睇清咗佢哋做事嗰啲 due diligence 做得点样啊，咁啊而家就展开为期两个月嘅咨询，咁问啊 Anthony 咧主席咧就系而家呢个证监会呢个咨询啊，咁啊话要收紧对保荐人嗰个资格啊资历啊啲监管是否能够真系有啲作用咧？
Right, I think, well, it's been well reported that the SFC, as you said, is undergoing a consultation with the community with regards to whether they should enhance the regulation around sponsors for IPOs. I think it's obviously there's still a lot of work to be done and the industry is yet to respond to the SFC, so we need to wait as an industry to see what those responses are. But I guess as... a professional institute, generally speaking, regulation towards core activities and functions are favourable in our view. We will not be the only country in the world to pursue this. our listeners out there will may or may not know that China today already regulates this activity, and therefore if Hong Kong should decide to regulate sponsors, we would be yet another country to do that. Regulation of sponsors, I think, will at least at a minimum provide some standard and core competency of our sponsors, and most importantly the ongoing training and sort of will enable us some sort of assurance that our sponsors do know and are kept up to date with the latest rules and regulations and also their responsibilities.
咁啊，呢次證監會就出諮詢文件啦，建議收緊咧對保薦人監管啦。當然香港而家係連續過往兩年，我記得起碼兩年咧，就 IPO 咧全世界冠軍啊。但係做 IPO 嘅過程之中啊，咁啊有好多中介團體噶，咁啊又有測量師啊、核數師啊、咁啊估值師啊、律師啊各方面啦，咁啊保薦人其中之一。咁但係呢次如果IPO 上市之后啲文件发生风波咧，咁系咪净系关保荐人士咧？咁呢个都系有疑问嘅。咁而家证监会啊，净系话要收紧对呢个保荐人嘅监管啊。咁你哋呢个专业团，你哋呢个专业团体有咩睇法啊？
我 I think any time when there's a new regulation that comes out, you know, the initial response from the industry is usually some pushback and say we don't need extra regulation.But I think history have taught us that Hong Kong have had very good regulation, and through this higher level of regulation, Hong Kong have actually performed better over this recent period, and particularly over this global financial crisis period, and have outshone many of our other competitors around this region, but also globally. So I personally believe that improved regulation will not necessarily lead to a reduction in the number of IPO. Quite the contrary, I think if we can sustain the quality of companies that are listed in Hong Kong over the long term, I think Hong Kong will actually see a much larger demand and supply of IPO.Then would be the case otherwise.
哦，咁啊，穆主席认为加强监管咧，就可能会增加嗰个上市 IPO 嗰个质素啊，咁啊，对长远嚟讲咧，对呢个市场反而好事。咁啊，因此加强监管呢个保荐人咧，应该就唔会阻慢呢个 IPO 个数目啊或者速度嘅。讲到呢度咧，时间已经差唔多够啦。今日好多谢香港证券专业协会嘅主席穆义堂先生，同埋香港证券专业学会嘅行政总裁。